Jeu de l'année 2013, jeu de la génération pour les lecteurs de Game Cult, succès aussi bien critique que commercial, The Last of Us a sans aucun doute possible marqué de son empreinte l'industrie du jeu vidéo. Un véritable aboutissement pour son studio créateur Naughty Dog, qui montait en puissance à chaque nouvelle PlayStation, d'autant plus avec sa série des Uncharted sur PS3. À quelques mois de l'apparition des consoles next-gen, The Last of Us sortait et restera dans les mémoires comme un jeu symbole concluant une génération, au même titre qu'un GTA V. Deux jeux ambitieux que l'on retrouve sans surprise adaptés sur la nouvelle génération, The Last of Us Remastered s'apprête à sortir au beau milieu de l'été, en période creuse, alors que la PS4 manque cruellement d'approvisionnement en jeu. Hormis le lifting graphique qui s'impose, les développeurs n'ont pas souhaité retoucher leur création.
When we were starting off working on The Last of Us Remastered, we were trying to figure out, you know, what types of things we wanted to do for sort of this improved version and the upgrades. And one of the things is, we're deciding if we wanted to do some changes to the gameplay mechanics or some parts. I mean, you obviously always look back and you're like, oh, I could have made that a little bit better, or, you know, you're getting feedback from the community about things. But we made a conscious decision not to change any of the gameplay. I think we're all familiar sometimes when movies come out with a remaster and they recut some stuff there's one in particular I'm thinking of where they change, you know, sometimes it changes the entire meaning of what it is. So we wanted to be faithful to the experience. And so this really is a remaster in the truest definition of the word. Once you start tweaking one thing, the way Naughty Dog is, we'll start tweaking something else, and I think then you would have seen Remastered maybe next year or the year after, right? By the time we get done with it. And it'd be a completely different game, actually, I think.
L'affichage en 1080p à 60 images par seconde et l'intégration du DLC Left Behind, prologue à l'histoire de The Last of Us, sont les principaux arguments de cette adaptation remastered. Récemment, Naughty Dog a également annoncé l'ajout d'un mode photo.
We put in a photo mode because the share button on the PS4 is an amazing tool, and we were seeing so much pickup on it. People were really excited about what they saw in Infamous when they were added into it, so we wanted to support that. So it's part of a day one patch. So when you get the game originally, you can turn off the HUD and the aiming reticle, so you can at least take screenshots without it. And on our day one patch, we're adding a screenshot tool that's adding a whole lot of features that you can use, you know, to basically, you can remove the camera and move it around. There'll be some filters and stuff. So just before the patch comes out, we'll announce like the full range of features, and we'll probably show you exactly what it looks like.
I need something smuggled out of the city.
Just cargo, Joel.
I just want some simple gear enough to set me on my way.
Cette nouvelle version est aussi l'occasion pour les développeurs d'implémenter des bonus, comme des commentaires audio à la manière de ceux que l'on trouve sur les films en DVD.
We're shitty people, Joel. It's been that way for a long time.
No, we are survivors.
This is our chance.
It is over, Tess!
So when we were finishing production on the PS3 version, Troy and Ashley sat down with our creative director, Neil, to do commentary over the cutscenes. And you guys were talking about sort of like the building, the performance capture, and your characters. And so we weren't able to put that on the PS3 disc, but thankfully we put it on The Last of Us Remastered.
Ellie. Ellie.
What?
The ladder. Come on.
Right.
After David, Ellie's visibly distant. You could have done a cutscene to show, hey, you're being very distant, and she's not responding, but to also do that in gameplay, to where it's something that you've done just countless times throughout the game with, you know, let me boost you up here, get the ladder, bring it down so we can do this systemic thing. And the character responds with that, and you have to actually go over to her and go, hey, come on, the ladder, we've done this, let's do this. It's a subtle choice.
Like Bruce and I talked from the beginning, is like, we have these mechanics, how can we exploit them in a narrative sense?
Ah, so good!
So once you've played through the games and unlocked all the cutscenes, you can go into a video gallery and rewatch each cutscene. You have an audio option to either watch the regular audio or to watch the commentary scene. I think that's really awesome. I think it's a really great addition for, I mean, I always watch commentary tracks on like movies when you have that on DVD. So I was really glad to be able to put that in there.
And especially this is when you do the audio commentary, it's the first time that we actually saw the game. So
It's a retrospective, but it's also our first impressions of seeing like these, of seeing the gameplay, and of seeing these cutscenes. So it's a pretty cool little insight into us. You'll hear me get pretty emotional in some parts.
I don't remember what we talked about. I'm anxious to hear it because I vaguely remember that.
I know for one specific example is. Sarah dying. That was the first time. So yeah, it's pretty brutal. It's a really cool additional feature.
I know it hurts, baby. I know. So I'm gonna lift you up. I'm gonna get you over here. Come on, baby. Come on, work with me, please. God, baby. Sarah. Don't do this to me, baby. Come on. Don't do this, please, God, no! Oh, God, no!
C'est désormais un procédé commun sur les AAA, la capture des mouvements, des expressions du visage et évidemment de la voix était d'usage dans The Last of Us. Moins courant par contre, ces trois phases ont été capturées en même temps sur le plateau de tournage pour toujours plus de crédibilité. Des scènes parfois éprouvantes qui constituaient un vrai challenge pour les acteurs.
Floor is yours.
And action.
I think more than anything, this game has changed all of us, from an acting standpoint, from even a personal standpoint, because now we have this family.
There are many like it, but this one is yours. Why don't you have a seat?
Yeah. All right, everybody calm down. Calm down. Thanks, guys.
Oh, man. This has been one of my favorite things that I've ever worked on across the board. And I think because we shot it for almost just our portion for up to 3 years, it took us a long time. I mean, not to mention how long it probably took everybody else that worked on the game. But, there were just so many amazing experiences, and you know, we all became family, and every day on set was you just felt really special.
This has been the first time that I've ever been able to, while playing something, fully divorce myself from that being me. I wouldn't change anything about this.
You are treading on some mighty thin ice here.
I'm sorry about your daughter, Joel, but I have lost people too.
You have no idea what loss is.
Everyone I have cared for has either died or left me. Everyone fucking except for you. So don't tell me that I would be safer with someone else, because the truth is I would just be more scared.
You know, this was the first time I've ever done a video game, so it's the first time that I've played myself in a video game. So I don't know if the experience was different for you, but it's definitely weird because it's not, you know, it's your voice and your body movement, but it's not the way you look.
This is fancy. You ever stay at a place like this?
Before it all went to shit, I mean.
No, this is too rich for my blood.
There were some lines, how I delivered them, or some things that I did that I would get annoyed with myself, and you know, annoyed with Ellie, like, get out of the way, or you know, just certain things or the way that I did things. But I think most of all I enjoyed it. I really enjoyed playing it.
Succès commercial rime bien souvent avec suite, la fin de The Last of Us laisse la porte ouverte à un deuxième épisode. Toutefois, The Last of Us 2 n'est pas encore annoncé par Sony.
What do we do?
You make every shot count.
Our approach for the way we always make games has always been to make sure that they're a self-contained story from start to beginning, because we we never plan anything as a franchise. I mean, even with Uncharted, when we were done with Uncharted Drake's Fortune, we thought, you know, we finished that story so that if that was the only game we would do, it you didn't feel like that something was lacking or that there could have been a sequel. I mean, I personally don't like it when you're watching something, it's movies mostly, but you're watching something and you're like, oh, it's there's totally going to be a sequel, right? And you know, like there's things that are unsaid. So we always try to avoid that. I think it always feels a little bit more satisfying, even when the endings are somewhat open-ended. I mean, I think our ending was, you know, there it is somewhat open-ended. You don't know what happens, but it does feel like it has this natural ending that it doesn't have to continue. So, you know, it's always up down to if we're excited and passionate about a story to tell, then we'll either continue the story or we'll think about working on something else.
It's a lot to take in, kid. Where do I even start? You've been out of the game for a long time.
Il y aura par contre une suite à Uncharted puisqu'un quatrième épisode est prévu sur PlayStation 4. Quand on demande à Arnie Meyer plus de précisions sur la date de sortie prévue l'année prochaine, il devient soudain un peu vague.
You're just gonna have to wait and see. We've been, yeah, it'll be in a month with an R in it.
Okay. That's
oh cool. Wow.
So not May. Not May. Oh, hey, that's a good one. I didn't think about that. Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah, there's
all right. That wasn't as clever as I thought it would be. How about a day with an R, a day that doesn't have an R in it? I guess it was Sunday. Yeah, okay, there we go. That's better.
Gotcha.
I'm not that clever, yeah. It's too early in the morning still.